Good evening to all of you. This is the second day of our session. So yesterday I introduced to you all about Python. We had something about how AI is used by Google. Particularly, we discussed about how Google Photos recognizes faces, and also I just showed you a brief demo using Google Maps, where artificial intelligent algorithms are used to keep track of our queries and then answer within no time. Right? Okay. So I think few students have joined today based on your queries. I can see that. So let me introduce myself again. I'm Dr. Prasanna Kumar, working as a faculty in the Department of Computer Science and Engineering, Amrita School of Engineering, Chennai. So Amrita School of Engineering, Chennai, actually under the Department of Computer Science and Engineering, is offering three courses under that. Three programs. One is Computer Science and Engineering. Another one is Computer Science and Engineering with specialization in Artificial Intelligence. And the third course is Computer Science and Engineering with specialization in Cybersecurity. So among all the Amrita campuses, Chennai campus is the first to offer cybersecurity, BTEC in cybersecurity. Okay, BTEC CSE with cybersecurity. Good. Okay, so this is all about myself. So this particular 5 days, we'll be learning something about face recognition using machine learning with Python. So I hope still some students I told please stop. Posting queries in the chat window now. Okay. So at the end of the session, I'll take your queries. So please don't post any questions now. If you're posting, I don't think I can answer now. Right. So for all your well-being, please stop posting queries in the chat or QA sessions. Good. So coming to the Python programming. So yesterday I just introduced to you about what is Python. Python was an interpreted language, and still there are questions like whether Python is good or bad. Okay, being an interpreted language, it does not. Talking about Python, actually Python is an interpreted language, but it does not mean that it is slow. Okay, even though it is. An interpreted language, it is as fast as other compiled programming languages also. So let me just go for the coding part today. We'll just have some basic coding. I'm not going to have some in-depth coding and all. We'll have some basic coding done today. Okay, so let me directly go to collaboratory. So I think in the collaboratory, I have opened a new notebook. Yeah, okay. So. For those who joined today, actually a brief introduction about the platform that I'm going to use today. Okay, even though I have IDLE installed in my system, I have installed it successfully, but IDLE has its own limitations. So I prefer to use this collaboratory, which is an online platform that is provided by Google. Okay, so let's start. Let's start coding. So I'm not going to code anything very difficult now. A very simple statement, right? See, for example, let's have some number like A equal to 7. Okay. And some number like B is equal to the same 7. Let me have this. And C is equal to A plus B. Okay. So let me just print. Let me print the value like C. Okay. So now this is a very simple Python program. You may be wondering, there is no integer, there is no float, nothing has been said. But since simply I have said A is equal to 7, if you have already some programming experience, you may be wondering like why that data types are not mentioned here. So Python actually, So Python, what it will do is, it will actually consider, it will actually take into consideration whatever data type has been given. So you can see that it is a very, very simple Python program. Anyone can do this, right? Even you can change your data. So data in the sense like I have used A as 7 and B as 7, C is equal to A plus B and print C. Okay, so actually in print statement, you have to give the values as parameters. Parameters in the sense you should use brackets. Okay, so since I just forgot to use bracket, it was not working properly. Okay, so actually, this is a very simple program for addition. Maybe I can even change this code for multiplication, just saying change the symbol. So you can see that I have changed to asterisk and I'm just running the program again. So now you can see that the output comes here below itself. Okay, now this is a very simple statement, very simple arithmetic operation that I have done. Okay, now what I'll do is there are different types of data that we use in Python. So first, let me just type or let me just do something about strings. Okay. So, okay. So what I'm going to do now is let me create a string. So how to create, sir, how to open? Yeah. So to open Collaboratory, you should have a Chrome browser, Google Chrome. In Google Chrome, you type C-O-L-A-B, okay? Collab, C-O-L-A-B, okay? So, but you should have a Gmail account for that. I hope everyone uses a, yeah, Jupyter, Spider, all looks the same. This is an online platform, what is it, created by Google. So this particular platform has provided a free of cost access to Google servers, particularly the GPUs. Okay, so for any machine learning algorithm, GPUs are compulsory, and buying a GPU enabled device will cost some 3 or 4 lakhs. Okay, which is not advisable for each and everyone. So if you want to do some machine learning programs, particularly if you use TensorFlow and all, okay. So if you use TensorFlow, you need some GPU. Actually, whatever processor in the CPU, we call it as CPUs, that is in the laptops. CPU stands for central processing units, which will not be of helpful, okay. So, instead of buying a laptop with a GPU, what we can do is we can use Collaboratory, which is provided by Google. Okay, so that's why I'm using this. Now, let me create a string. We'll see some basic programming today. I'm not going to deal in-depth programming. So how to create a string? Let me call that string as str. I should give some name, no? So I'm giving it as str. And let me call, see, I just typed only one single quotes, but actually the Collaboratory, what it will do is it will by default, insert the second quote. Okay. Now, so I have typed, sorry, I have created a string str equal to Python. Okay, now, for example, if I try to assign or if I want to print this value, it's very simple. How should I print? I should use the command called as print and within bracket str, that's all. So, I have to run this code. You can see that play button. So we have to press that. You can see that it prints the word Python. So I have created a string. Okay. Do you understand? I have created a string. Okay. So that string name is str and I have just printed it out. This is the basic operation that I have used. Now, what are the various operations that I can perform? Okay, that's very important. So maybe I'll just type here the operations that we can perform on strings. Okay, I'll insert a text after this. So what are the operations in the sense? We can do indexing. Okay, second one is we can do slicing. Third one is concatenation. I'll explain each and every term. Don't worry if you're not familiar with that. And the next one is repetition, and also we will see another thing called as membership. Okay, so these are the five operations that we are going to see. One is indexing, slicing, concatenation, repetition, and membership. Okay, now so let me just show you the first one, indexing. What is indexing? Okay, so we have, okay, I'll just yeah, so already I have created a string that's called as str, and the data stored in that is Python. Now let me see how this indexing works. It's quite simple. So what I have to do is str, okay, use a pair of opening and closing square brackets, okay, zero. So the index value normally will start with zero. So I'll just run this code. Can anyone tell me what will be the answer? Oh, sorry. Okay, so what will be the answer for this? Okay, str of zero is p. So normally the index value starts with p. Okay, so sorry, index value starts with zero. So if I change this to one instead of zero, it will print me y. Okay, str of one is y. So this type of indexing, we call it as positive indexing. So p is having an index value zero, y is having an index value one, t will be having two, h will be having three, o will be having four, and n will be having five. Okay, so let me just check if str of five is n. Okay, so yes, you can see the output, it is n. Okay, so Python has got six alphabets. Okay, among this six, p will be assigned with zero, and consecutive numbers will be assigned with 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, this is called as positive indexing. What is this called as? This is called as positive indexing. Okay, now we have another thing called as negative indexing. So what is this negative indexing? See, the same print statement I'm going to use, print. Okay, so let me put minus one. So minus one here refers to the value which is at the end of the string. Okay, so let me run this code. You have to press this button so you can see that. Sorry, I have not typed str, right? So str of minus one. Okay, so it, you can see that the output is n. So what is this called as? This is called as negative indexing. This is called as negative indexing. Okay, now let me change this to some minus two. So what will happen? Minus two will give you the element which is before that, that is O. Similarly, if I type minus three here, it will give me H. Okay, so it will be considered from the reverse values. So this is what we call it as indexing. So there are two types of indexing. One is positive indexing and another one is negative indexing. Now, I hope it is clear to all. Okay, so we'll just move to the next concept, that is slicing. So what is this slicing, and how slicing will be useful? So let me just go to the code again. Okay, okay, it's here, right? I'll create a code here. Okay, it's not. Yeah. So what is slicing? It's a very interesting concept, actually. Okay, so let's use the same str equal to Python here also. See, slicing uses the colon, actually. Colon is used here. So str, okay, so within square brackets, what I have to do is, for example, I just want only, okay, so you can see that, okay, let me just give 0:4. Okay, colon is nothing but the two dots are there. So you can see that str, open a square bracket, 0:4. So what will happen to this means, starting from the zeroth element, it will print four elements, four alphabets that are in the string. So it will print pyth. You know that str is nothing but Python. So 0:4, that is 0:4, will print from the starting value 0 to the fourth element. Okay. So not actually here, 0 to 4 in the sense it will print four numbers, not fourth element. Okay. So 0, 1, 2, 3 are printed. I think you can see that. So here, that last number includes the numbers. It will be excluded from the substring. Okay. See? This 4 refers to the fourth element.
So which will be excluded, right? Fine. So the we'll have some more examples here. Let me just remove this 0. Okay, and then let me type some value like 3. Okay, I have removed 0 here. I have not set 0. But I'm just telling the end value. Can you tell me what will be the output? It will print PYT. Okay. So PYT, the three elements will get printed. Okay. See, I am not going to give the end value, but let me give only the starting value. Let me give it as a 0. So I'm not giving the termination condition. In the sense, it will print the entire thing. You can see that PYTHON is printed. Okay. Now, instead of 0, let me start with 2 and then print to 5. Okay. So in Python, it will start, it will leave that PY. If you can see that THO, the mid string has been printed here. So this is what we call it as slicing. Yes, L-I-C-I-N-G. Okay. So as I told you, slicing is nothing but, I think you know slices, right? Mango slice or even pineapple slice, something like that. So whichever portion we want, we'll be in a position to print. Okay, this is one of the operations. So we have discussed about indexing, positive and negative, and we have discussed about slicing. So the next thing is, let's go for the third operation on string, concatenation. Okay, so how does this concatenation work? So concatenation means it requires a minimum of two elements. Okay, in a sense, two strings will be required. So already one string is there, and let me create another string. String one is equal to, okay, let me give Python. Okay. So string one is, programming language. Now, let me implement my concatenation. So it's very simple. I can use a print statement directly. Print str plus str one. Okay, so what is str? Python. What is str one? Str one is programming language. So the output will be Python programming language. Okay, so you can see the output, like both the strings are concatenated with each other. So we use the plus operator for this. What operator we use? We use the plus operator. Okay, so this is what we call it as concatenation. Okay, if we want three strings also, you can do it. For example, let me create another string, str2 is equal to Python programming language. Is easy to learn. Okay. So I have to run this. No output will be there. And then I'll add these things. So let me copy this. Let me paste here. Plus str2. Okay. So you can see that Python programming language is easy to learn. So this is what we call it as concatenation, addition of two strings. Okay. So the next one is repetition. Repetition means if I want to repeat the same string again and again, okay, same string again and again, I can go for repetition. So how can I do it? We use that asterisk symbol for this. We use asterisk symbol. For example, I want str1 to be printed 3 number of times. Okay, so str1 asterisk. Okay, that is the multiplication, sorry. You have to use asterisk 3. So asterisk is used for repetition. If I give the output, that is if I run this code, you can see that programming language. It is repeated 3 number of times. So this is what we call it as repetition. Even I can change, instead of string 1, I can print string 2 also. That is easy to learn. It will be repeated 3 number of times. You can see that. Okay. Or even I can print that string 2 times. That is, Python will be printed 2 number of times. Okay. You can see Python and Python. Okay. So this is what we call it as repetition. So the various operations that are that can be performed on a string are indexing, slicing, concatenation, repetition, and membership. I hope everything is clear to all of you, right? Okay. So membership I did not teach, right? Okay, sorry, I forgot. Let's just think about what is this membership. Okay. See, if I want to check, okay, if a particular word, a particular alphabet is in a string. So P, okay, I have to give within double quotes. So, okay, I'll give capital P. Okay, in is the operator used here, IN, okay, in STR. So what it will do is, it will check if this P is in str. Python we gave, oh, I think it is true. So it will give the answer as true. Okay, so P is in str. Let me try if the same P is in str1. What is str1? It is programming language. Yes, of course, P is in str1 also, it will say true. But what about str2? It's easy to learn, so P is not here. Now let me try with str2. We have created 3 strings here. One is str, str1, and str2. You can see that in str2 is easy to learn. So P in str2 will give you false. Okay. So you can see that it is very simple. Only IN. Okay. So this is the membership operator. Okay. This is membership operator. We have another operator also here. Okay. So what we can do is, okay, so P not in str2. So what is this? It will be giving true to us. Okay, so not in is a membership operator which will say true if that element is not present. So whereas if you give a check in str, the answer will be false. Why? Because str is Python. We have created str. Where is str? Yeah, str here. Str is Python. So P is present in Python. So if I ask whether P is not present in string, it will give the answer as false. Okay. So true and false are the Boolean operators that we use in this Python programming. Okay. So these are the operations that we use over strings. Okay. Now I just want to introduce two more concepts. One is a list. Okay. So what is a list? A list is nothing but it is a collection of elements. Okay. So it's an ordered sequence of items. I'll repeat again. So maybe I'll type also. A list is a okay, so list is an ordered sequence of items. Now, what are the operations that we can perform on a list? Okay, so like we can perform indexing. Slicing concatenation repetition updation membership and the comparison. So these are the seven operations that we are going to discuss under this list, list. Okay, so first of all, we have to create a list. Just as we created a string, we have to create a list. How to create a list? It is very simple. Okay, so let's create a list with the name list. Okay, list is equal to, you have to open square bracket and close the square bracket. Okay, so what we'll do is we'll create a list with someone. Okay, so you can see that I'm creating a list with 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9 10. Okay, now a list has been created. So let me print this. So how to print this? Print print. So we have to use open bracket, close bracket, give that value list. Okay, so you can see that a list has been printed. The most important thing that you have to watch here is the list is being printed in square brackets. You can see in the output a square bracket is there at the start and the at the end. Okay, so list will be always printed in square brackets. So this is a very, it's very simple to create a list. List is nothing but some ordered sequence of items. Okay, so here we are having only numbers. Okay, 1 to 10. So as what is it, first thing we have created. So what is the operation that I told? First we'll be performing indexing. So what is indexing? It is the same as we discussed with strings. So print, we have to use brackets here. So list, the name of the list, and within square brackets what you have to do is you have to give the list index value. So as earlier, the index value starts with 0. Okay, since here also we have two indexing, positive and negative, same as that of strings. Strings actually deals with alphabets, whereas here we are dealing with some numbers. Okay, so what will be the answer? The answer will be 1. Okay, so if I print a list of 3, the answer will be 2. List of 3 is 4. 0, 1, 2, right? 1, 2, 3. The answer will be 4. Similarly, we have negative indexing here. There, I can give minus 1. So you can see the print list of minus 1. So what will be the answer? It is 10. So 10 means it is negative indexing. So it prints the last number. If I am printing minus 2 here, it will be printing 9. Okay, so this is what we call it as indexing. Next one, let's go for slicing. So for slicing, what we did earlier, do you remember that we used this something like this, right? So similarly, we use a colon here. So we use like print list. So we can use from 2:6. Okay. So what it will do? It will print the values like 3, 4, 5, 6. That is from index value 2, it prints the next 4 values. Okay, so this is what we call it as indexing. Okay, so slicing, I'm sorry. So in slicing also, we can start with the 0th element. So it will print from 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. Okay, so or you can delete this element and give only colon and 6. It'll print like the same answer 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Or if I give the entire elements 10, it'll print the entire list. There is no slicing done here. Whereas if I want from the fifth element, I can give 5, 10, which will print from the 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. Okay, so this is what we call it as slicing. Okay, so next one is concatenation. So what is concatenation? Addition of two lists. So then I should have another list. Okay, so let me create like list one. Okay, so let me have some elements in list one, maybe 11. Okay, so 11, 12, 13, 14, and 15. Sorry, it should be equal to here. Okay. Okay, so it will create list one. Okay, so I'm not printing here anything, but if you want, I can print for our purpose, print within brackets list one. Okay, so it'll give the output 11, 12, 13, 14, and 15. You can see that the output is given in square brackets. Okay, so once this is done, we can go for concatenation. So how should we do that? Can anyone tell me what was the operator that we used? Yes, plus, very good. So list plus list one, that's all. So what will be the output? 1 to 15. You can see that 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, and 15. So this is what we call it as concatenation. Okay, so what is the next one? Repetition. So for repetition, what we can do? Print list one, maybe asterisk two times. So it'll just print list one twice, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. So you can see that this is one time and this is second time, first time and second time. Okay, this is what we call it as repetition. So you can see here, we have discussed all these things before itself, indexing, slicing, concatenation, and repetition. Now, I think the spelling is wrong here. Okay, let it be. So next one is, let's go for updation. Okay, so how can we update? Okay, so what is updation? For example, I don't want 11, 12, 13, 14, 15 in list one, but I want 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. Okay. So for that, I can insert an element. But before insertion, let me explain about updation. So what I can do is, let me show one small demo, like print list one. Second element. So what will be the output here? It will be 13. Now let me change this. Okay, how can I change that? How I can change like list one, that is name of the list, index value 2, okay, is equal to, instead of this 13, let me give 130. Okay, let me give 130. So now, if I print this list one again, okay, so print list one. See, the values will be 11, 12, 130, 14, and 15. It is not 13 since we have changed here. This is what we call it as updation. So you can see that the output is 130 here. Okay, so this is updation, and next let's go for membership. So what is membership? It's quite simple, 11 in list. What will be the answer, true or false? 11 in list. False, yeah. So list has got only from 1 to 10. So if I print 11 in list 1, it will say it is true, since in list 1 we have 11. Okay, yes. So this is what is about membership. Similarly, we have not in. So 11, not in list 1. What will be the answer? It will be false. Whereas if I give 11 not in list, it will say true. Why? Because list consists of 1 to 10. Okay. So this is what we call it as membership. Next one is comparison. So when will it be true? If both the lists are the same, it will be true. But see, first list we have 1 to 10. Second list we have like 11, 12, 130, 14 and 15. Now let me check. List is equal to, you have to, what is it? Use twice the equal to operator. You can see that. List 1. So the answer will be false. Okay. Now let me create another list. Maybe list 2. Equal to okay. So now let me compare list 1 is equal to list 2. What will be the answer? Okay, sorry, I should, I have to use equal to, okay. So you can see that the answer is true here. Okay, similarly, I can have like not equal to, for that we use the exclamation symbol. Okay, so list 1 not equal to list 2 will give you false, whereas list 1 is not equal to list will give you true. Okay. So this is not equal to, that is exclamation followed by equal to. Okay. So this is what comparison operation on a list can refers to. Okay. So next one we have like slicing. I hope the same slicing that we have done earlier. Okay. So I think we have done slicing earlier here, right? Okay. So it's like list within square brackets, maybe 0 to 3. So it will print the 0th element, first element, and the second element. That is, the output will be 1, 2, 3. Okay. So next one is, what we can do is, for example, there is an option called as step here. Okay. Okay. Exclamation symbol actually refers to negation. Okay. So in this slicing, we have a concept called as step value. So how to use that? See, list, what is list actually? I think you can recollect 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. I want, okay, only elements from 0 all up to some, all the 10 elements, but with a step of 2. So the output will be quite interesting here. It prints only the odd numbers since the step value is 2. Okay. So like 1, 3, 5, 7, and 9. Okay. See, similarly, what I can do is, if I give like 1, it will be printing like 2, 4, 6, 8, and 10. Okay, this is called as step in slicing. So we can give this number after another colon. We have to use 2 colons here if we want to use step. Okay, so the last one is like, even I can print that list in the reverse order. Okay, so how to print the list in the reverse order? It's quite very simple. So what you have to do is list, open bracket, you type 2 colon, 2 times colon minus 1. Okay. So the output will be the reverse of what the list was given. See 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Okay. So I can reverse the list by using this slicing also. So just give 2 times colon and at the end minus 1. So these are some of the steps. Okay. So we have certain methods or functions. Okay, generally we call it as methods in Python for handling this list. Okay, so There are almost 15 methods that are used here in Python. So let me just show you one or two examples. Okay. Methods that we use. So for example, list dot append. So what is append? Append means it will add some element to the list. So let me give like 11. So what will happen here? What is list? List is 1 to 10. So now if I print a list, okay, you can see that the list has got the 11th element included here. Okay, since I executed the program twice, it has been implemented twice, otherwise only one time it will just get appended. Append means insertion, but at the end. Okay, append means insertion at the end. But I don't want to get that inserted at the end, but I want some element to be inserted at the start. So how can I do it? So name of the list dot insert. Insert is the command. Okay, so followed by the element I want to insert, 0, in 0th position. Let me tell that in the 0, 0. Okay, so first 0 refers to the index, that is where I have to insert, and second refers to the element that I want to insert. So it will be 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. So, okay, I did not print. Sorry. Okay, I'll use a different print statement, otherwise two zeros will get inserted. So print list. Print list. So you can see that a 0 will be inserted at the start. Okay, so I can insert at anywhere. Let me insert 0 at some 5th position. Okay, let me run the code. 5th position, I'm inserting 0. What will happen to the list? You can see that in the 5th position, 0 has been inserted. Can you see that, all of you? I have highlighted that. Okay, anywhere you can insert. You can insert at the start or anywhere between the thing. Okay, fine. So now what are the other things that we can do? Like what we can do is there are other methods like sorting, reverse. Okay, let's use this sort. Let's use for sorting for this. So print, I think list one. So what are the elements of list one? 11, 12, 130, 14, 15. They are not in the sorted order. Am I right? Okay, so I'll use a sort method to sort this one. So list one dot sort, S-O-R-T. Okay, so open bracket, close bracket. You have to give this, that's very important. Okay, so I have to print it again. So maybe let's copy this. So you can see the output 11, 12, 14, 15, and 130. So just it's very simple to add an element into the list. Okay. And we can remove an element from a list. For example, this 130 looks odd. So I want to remove that. So how can I do that? So list one dot remove, R-E-M-O-V-E. Okay, so what element I want to remove? 130. Okay. Now if I print list one, you can see that 130 is removed from the list. Okay, so these are few functions which we can use. And also like we can count the number of elements or we can find the maximum, minimum, etc. Okay, let me just show it. So what will be the answer? The answer will be 11. Okay, can you see that? So similarly,
What will be the answer? The answer will be 15. So min, M-I-N, M-A-X.
See, doing programming in Python is a very easy thing. Okay, you can see the coding is very simple. If you want to do the same thing in other, programming languages, it will be very tedious. But in Python, it is so simple that you can do it in no time. Okay, so just a minute, I'll post the attendance. Just a minute.
Okay, no problem. Anyway, I have posted it again. So what's happening here? Yeah, so minimum, maximum, I can do that. And even I can find the length, L-E-N, that's all. Length of, let me put only for list. So I think it was 13 elements were there, no? 0 to, yeah, 14, sorry. 11 was inserted twice. So you can see that if you want, I'll print the list again here. It is list, not list one. Okay, so you can see that the number or numbers are inserted here. Okay, the entire length of the list can be given. So if you count, 11 elements will be there here. Okay, fine. Yeah, sorry, I'll take it full screen. Okay, so if I want to clear the entire contents, it's very simple. List dot okay, so length of a list will give the total number of elements in a list. So here is the list. You can count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. So the answer is 14. Okay, yeah. Okay, so the next one is like a clear. Let me clear the list. So list dot cl. Oh, sorry. List dot clear. Open bracket, close bracket. So just send. Okay. So okay, so you can see that nothing will be there in the list. It is an empty list. Okay, since I have cleared the entire contents which are present in the list. Okay, so these are a few list operations that can be done. Okay, so yeah, I think with this, I'll just wind up my presentation on this topic, Python programming. So this is just an introduction. This is just to show you that Python is a very simple programming language. You can see that all the operations are done with very simple commands. Okay, it's not so tough to write a code or write programs in Python. So I have just introduced only two things today. One is strings and another one is a list. Okay, so yeah. So you can make use of this Colab platform so that you can make use of write some machine learning based programs, okay, easily without any hiccups. Okay, fine. So we'll just wind up this class. So regarding few of your queries, I think today the chat window is not that much going in the correct manner. Unnecessary things are being posted here. So yeah, actually attendance just now I have posted, but anyway, I'll post it again, no problem. Okay. Yeah, if you have any queries, maybe we'll just use this session and you can ask some queries if you have. Okay, yeah. I thought I'll be explaining about GitHub to you. Yeah. So what is this GitHub and what is this Kaggle? Okay, fine. So I'll just open that. Okay, see, GitHub is actually a repository. So repository means it is nothing but it is a place where the programmers, what they can do is they can post their own programs. For example, I don't want to get inside this much. Let me just go and explore. Okay, so let me go for some topics. I can use the search here. You can see that search GitHub. So Python programming. Okay, so you can see that there are 97,066 repository results, or that is 97,066 people have created some programs and they have uploaded it here. Okay, so now let me just open one thing. Like you can see n number of programs has been written. So maybe initially it will be too tough for you to understand what are the things here. But anyway, let me just go for a simple one. Python programming exercises. So for example, you can see that the coding is the coding as well as the document files will be green here. I'll open this document. So I think nothing is in there in the doc. Yeah, so here they have given. So 100 plus Python challenge programming exercises. So they have split into different levels. You can see that in this particular repository have got the question and also the relevant Python coding for that. Okay. Similarly, there is another question and the coding for this. So what you can do is you can save it. You can see that there is an option for saving. You can save it in your local machine and you can run this code. Okay, so this is not only for Python. Let me just go for like machine learning using Python. So you can see that, I should have searched in GitHub, not in that repository. Yeah, so you can see that there are n number of programs written, and maybe if I want Python only, you can see that 3,120 people have posted. So it's based on some stock market prediction, something like that. So you can see currentdata.py. So you can see the Python program. Okay, so you can download this code, you can copy this code, and then you can run it on your system or even in your collaboratory. Okay, so what is the advantage of this? Okay, see, when you write any program, let it be a very simple program, if you just write that, if you write the code and then upload it here, what will happen here means the employers will be watching whatever you're doing. So we have a leaderboard here, and that leaderboard will take you to places where, for example, I'll just go for Kaggle. So Kaggle is also another website where we get the data set, particularly for machine learning and other projects. Okay,
So here, what is there is they conduct n number of competitions. You can see that n number of competitions occur in Kaggle. So we can start something here. For example, there is a competition that is presently going on, 2 months to go. So something around $1 lakh. That is one. Okay. So here you can see that they'll give the description and evaluation. What is the timeline for that? So May 17, it started, and it will end in September 19, 2021. So you have to write code for that. So they'll give all the requirements. So you need a GPU. So, and this program will run approximately for less than or equal to 9 hours. So your laptop will not do this work. So only Google Colab you can make use of, or if you have a high-end computing facility, maybe we call it as high-performance computing labs, okay, which are very costly. If you have access to that, maybe you can do that. Otherwise, it's better you can use Google Colab. Only thing is that for that 9 hours, no interruption in your network should happen. Okay, so this is actually partnered with HP and Intel. So these are the two companies, they have sponsored this particular thing. Okay, now coming to this, you can see if you just go for the home, you can see that n number of persons are writing their code. You can see 50,000 public data sets and almost 4 lakh public notebooks. So notebook is where you can find the entire code. Okay, so our interest is this face detection. Okay, so face detection also, you can see that they give the data. So you can see that data path, and 10 members have shared their codes. Okay, so if you want, you can open this code and see what's written there. Okay, so you can see that code. You can see here some code, some lines of code here, some lines of codes here. They are using a JSON file for that. So okay, something like that. So this is Kaggle, where you can get the data sets, and also Kaggle regularly introduces many, regularly they will be updating with n number of competitions, which anyone can participate by forming a team or individual. Normally teamwork is appreciated here. And see, you can form a team across the universities. It does not mean that you have to be from a particular university. And also they have many courses. So what are the courses? You can see that basic Python. So yesterday somewhere asking like where we can learn. So you can learn Python here in Kaggle, Kaggle, in under courses. You can have introduction to machine learning, intermediate machine learning, somewhat advanced level. You can learn pandas, data visualization. I think I told you yesterday about data visualization. You can study feature engineering, data cleaning, and someone was asking about SQL. So even you can study SQL here, okay, in Kaggle. Okay, so this is a very good platform where they will start from the basics, and they will be teaching you to the advanced level. Most of them are free of cost. Okay, so you can learn very good things like computer vision, where image recognition and all they use it. And also they have very good courses on AI ethics and deep learning and machine learning explainability. So natural language processing and game AI for and reinforcement learning, something like this. Okay, yeah, so you can make use of this and you can start learning. Learning is really fun, particularly when you use Python. It'll be really interesting for you guys to learn something. Okay, so this is what I just wanted to tell today. And I'd like to play one video for you guys, but I don't know how many of you have watched that. Okay, I don't know whether the audio will be there, but it's a 3-minute video. Can you hear the audio? No.
Okay, but anyway, I'll just explain. It's not a problem. See, what will happen here is that this is a robo, which you can see on your right-hand side is a robo. And the car in which that robo is sitting is an autonomous vehicle. Okay, in a sense, it's a self-driven car. You can see that the car is driven at 100 miles per hour. If you just see that speedometer, see, he's not using his hands. You can see that it's, it's crossing 100. Okay, so no caption also there. So you can see that this car drives on its own in a heavily, heavy traffic road. You can see that it changes the lane. You can see that it is using the indicator. It moves towards the right. And and also you can see it will be overtaking vehicles whenever it is there. And this robo, that is this Sophia, actually will learn from how this driving happens. So it will be keeping on commenting. Maybe you can watch in your YouTube later with the audio also. So what is the purpose of this particular thing to be shown here? As yesterday, few people were asking about what is the role of AI and what, see, both these things are a product of artificial intelligence. Okay, so we use neural networks to design this robo. Okay, the mechanical parts, it's very, it's already done. It is not at all a matter of concern, but you can see that the learning capability. We use neural networks here for this robot to learn. Maybe I think you might have seen some movies also where robo will learn on its own and it will attack the person who created something like that. Okay, so maybe 2.0, some movies like that are there. Okay, so this particular vehicle, you can see that it is overtaking on its own. It's not taking the help from the driver, right? He's also a professor. I should not call him a driver. He's a professor, basically. So he's a doctorate and he's working in some Audi Institute. So what it uses, you can see that it uses a lot of ultrasonic sensors and it uses a LIDAR to get the updated data, and it has got some radar sensors and all. So, and the process has to be done in real time. Okay, so it has to be process has to be done within no time, otherwise a accident will happen, right? So you can see that it's okay, it's driving without any hiccups in this traffic oriented road, right? That too, not at slow speed and all, something around 100 miles in the sense it will be something like 150 kilometers per hour, if I just want to say it in our context. Okay, so this is one thing. Okay, another thing just I wanted to show to you is, okay, yeah, so this is another interesting thing where AI is used in the entertainment industry. Okay, so particularly they use it for it's a very lengthy thing, but I'll just forward it and show where we want. So you can see that there is a human face here, and based on the human face, see how the system automatically creates images. Okay, this we call it as GAN. Okay, so there are n number of GANs. GANs means generative adversarial network. Artificial images out of the thing. So this is very interesting. So what happens here is that, instead of getting the real models, okay. So I think you can see that faces, no? See, none of these people are real. So what will happen if I just want an actor to come for a photo shoot? I have to spend lakhs of money and I have to have a very good environment for a photo shoot. I should have good lighting capabilities, a very good camera, very good camera professionals, lighting professionals, directors. So I have to spend lakhs of rupees for a photo shoot, even for a simple dress like this. But see, this GANs, what they do is they generate artificial people. You can see that these people never exist, but
Just look at their faces. Do you believe that they are not human beings? No one will say that he is not a human being, but they are not real human beings. So they are actually generated by these GANs. Okay. So you can see that these girls are also, you can see, they are generated by this artificial intelligent thing. So how do they generate means? They extract the features of human beings. Okay, eyes from one person, nose from one person, and mouth from one person, etc. And then they create. Example, where some images of different people are there, out of which you can see on the right hand side, they have created another image. This is one example for GANs. There is another interesting thing with a single person itself. Even you can, So you can fix the amount of happiness, amount of sadness, and whether they are young, old, etc. Maybe if you watch this entire video. So what is this? We need some NVIDIA based devices which are really, really costly to do this. So maybe you can use, see this video also, like some person is talking about something. But actually this person never talked like that. Okay. So we call it as deep fake videos. Okay. Which is also done by, it is just like Nixon speaking something, but actually Nixon did not talk that. So even nowadays, people can create this deep fake videos by using this GANs. Okay, so you can create video, you can create images, you can do anything artificially. So it is really a wonderful platform, and AI really will do wonders in the future. So this is where AI is used in the entertainment industry, like photography, for example. Most of the images that you see in e-commerce websites, particularly in Amazon and Flipkart and all, they are artificial faces. Only few are real models. Most of them are artificial images created by using GAN, G-A-N. Okay. So this is quite an interesting thing. I hope it's a wonderful information to you all. So with this, I'll just wind up my part of class, and maybe I'd like to take some questions now. And please don't post questions regarding what about Samsung girl? Okay. How to clear a list? Yeah, you can give the list.clear, C-L-E-A-R, open bracket, close bracket. That's all. It'll clear the entire list. Yesterday's session of class, I'll try to do it, but I don't have it. I think tomorrow one Nija ma'am will come, Nija Mohan ma'am will come. She'll be helping out to get all these details. Difficult to remember. Yeah, video is there. You can anyway watch it later. Yeah, thank you.
So thank you so much for the wonderful session, sir. Regarding this, the yesterday's session, everything will be available in our web page. So I'll share that link here.
Yeah. Okay. So next is, I think, any questions? Any reference book for Python? Yeah. See, you can use this python.org. So this is the authentic source for all the Python related code. So you can use Python dot, cybersecurity. We have another session from next Monday to Friday. Maybe they'll give more introduction about cybersecurity there next week. Okay. So any questions there in the chat window? Maybe I'll try to answer some few. Okay, which rank do I get? Sir, what about this admission related queries, sir? There are a few queries.
Yes, regarding the admissions related queries, you can reach out to amrita.edu. I'll just share the webpage. You can talk to our counselors at any time. Okay, so.
Okay.
We just request all the students to join. to amrita.edu. There will be some Instagram pages. There will be many promotions which are happening. So we just request students to join via Instagram and other things for updates. And you can interact with the counselors during the working hours and get clarified.
Yeah, okay. So I have just few queries, sir, which I'd like to answer now. What is the difference between positive and negative indexing? Positive indexing means it will start from the zeroth value and proceed like 0, 1, 2, 3. Negative indexing means it will start from the ending of the string or the list. Okay, and it will come in the reverse order. Okay, popping means it will be removing one element from the list. So that is what we call it as pop. Will you give certificate for learning this Python, this program? Sir, is there any certification to the students, sir?
Yes, certifications will be provided. So kindly fill in this attendance sheet. It will be taken care of. You will be intimated on that.
Okay. So can you share contact from administrative side? I have few queries. Okay. Anyway, I think they'll be giving it to you. Don't worry. And even the webinar links they have given in the website. What is a linked list? Is it easier to learn on Python or C++? See, writing Python code is very simple. Very, very simple to write a code in Python. Whereas in C++ and Java, it's a little bit, program oriented. You have to write a lot of code. Linked list is nothing, but it will be having some nodes. Okay, each node will have two parts. One is the data part and the address part. It is just like a train. So you can see that there will be an engine and the engine will have link to the next compartment, something like that. So in the compartments, people will be there, that we call it as the data, and the link will be given to the next compartment. That is called as a linked list, to be very simple. Okay, Shreya, you have put Python dot ?? I don't know what is the purpose of that. I don't know what is membership and all. Can you please tell something about data science? See, data science is a part of artificial intelligence, which is more oriented towards the statistical analysis of data. Okay. In case we want to import a file from our computer and use it for file handling related programs. You can upload, Shivani, you can upload programs into Colab without any issues. We have only just one line of code for that. It will ask you to upload that file and you can upload that. Yeah, certificates will be given. I think I've answered what is a linked list. Sir, how to save coding? Yeah, whatever I've done now, it will be stored in my collaboratory. So whenever I want, I can open that and see that. Yeah, it is very informative. Thank you. Positive, negative, okay. Which type of laptop should we use? Okay, see, actually what we do is in Amrita University, when the students join us based on his course and department, we'll be giving the specification to the students so that they can go and buy their own laptops of their choice and their wish. But we prefer something, laptops with some 16 GB of RAM, 15 inch of monitor and some Intel processor, maybe i5 or i7, okay. So yeah, Shivani, I think I answered your query. Okay. So will Mac R M1 2020 will be the best for CSE? Yes, actually, I referred to my faculty, as I told you yesterday. They told that Mac R for M1 will be very good for the entire CSE curriculum. Yeah, you can do your BTech for 5 years. Maybe even for your industry purpose, it will be of great use. Okay. Colab does have some disadvantages. Yes, it has one disadvantage that you should be connected to the internet. Other than that, nothing is disadvantages there. Okay. If you have an internet, if you have a system with a Gmail account and Google Chrome, it will do. Nothing more than that. Okay. Sri Krishna, I don't know what is this membership. I'm not able to get. YouTube video from complete Python. Okay. Okay. That maybe I have not checked it. I'll check it and tell it in the next class. So if you want to get input from the user, we have certain programs to be done. We have to write a class for that. And since in Python, everything will be treated as a class, that's somewhat advanced programming, which I don't think we'll be dealing in these 5 days. But if you just join any engineering course, I think they will be teaching for you. Python is used in cybersecurity. Yes, Gokul, Python is used in cybersecurity. Yeah, tell me about data science. I think I told data science is nothing but like it'll be having more of artificial intelligence with statistics and data analytics. No, list is not a keyword, actually, Sanjay. A list is a concept. I can use it. It's not a problem. No, there is no membership in Python and all. There is nothing like that. You can learn Python and there is a leaderboard in GitHub as well as in Kaggle. So the industries will be having a watch on that. And if you really excel in that, companies will directly call you. Okay. And even we have some platforms like HackerEarth, HackerRank, where more competitions will be there and they'll be running it. So for tomorrow, we'll be starting actually machine learning from tomorrow. We can use negative index in slicing. No, we cannot give negative indexing. Okay, Jogi Shanmukh, I think I started with the basics. I hope you understood at least what I did. Maybe you cannot remember what all I did, but you it's I just introduced and so that you may be what is it? Just a step to your first. What is it? You may be stepping in now, but actually, practice makes programming easier. How can I print my name? Only just use print and within brackets, within double quotations, you type your name and run the code. It'll print your name. What is a tree graph? Actually, tree and graph are two different concepts in data structures of computer science. Okay, a graph will have a cycle, whereas a tree will not have a cycle. It will have nodes and vertices and edges. So an edge is nothing but a circle. It will be normally represented by a circle and a vertex by a line. So a tree with a cycle, we call it as a graph. Okay, Sartak. So you'll be discussing about these trees and graphs in a subject called as data structures in computer science and engineering stream. Okay, Nagavarappu, which subject are you teaching in CSC branch? So actually I teach subjects like C, C++, Python programming, machine learning, time series analysis, compiler design, theory of computation. So these are a few subjects that I teach regularly. What is the name of the video about AI? And you told you will show one video about how much demand will increase in AI in the future. The demand in AI, just I showed two videos, no? One with an autonomous car, another one with the entertainment industry, GANs. Okay, so that is to illustrate that how industry are moving from the traditional mechanical way to intelligent manner, okay? So all will be talking about AI in the future and all the works will be AI based only. If you need to get input from the user, you have to create an object, and for that object you have to create a class, and from that class you can actually get input. There is a command called as input, just like print. There is a command called as input, which you can use to get the input. Explain how Python is useful in daily life. See, most of the programs or most of the applications that you use in our day-to-day life uses Python. Okay, so from that onwards, you can understand that Python is very important for all your technical needs. Okay, day-to-day in the sense, we will not be using that for basic coding and all, but we will be using that for some higher end machine learning kind of stuff. What is the difference between CSE, ECE, and mechanical engineering? Okay, CSE actually deals with more oriented towards computing stuff, in the sense programming, how to design a computer, etc. Electronics actually deals with electronic components like integrated circuits and communication. Communication means like 3G, 4G and all, 5G and all. Mechanical engineering, ME, they study about machines. Okay, they won't be studying automobiles, but they'll be studying about machines. Automobiles are different from machines. Okay, like they'll be studying about how an engine works, how an IC engine works, etc. This is for Hari Prithvi. So name is Sanjeevan. Is machine learning good scope in future? Yes, of course. It is a sub domain of artificial intelligence, and we have very good scope for machine learning. I answered for Hari. I think. Okay, blockchain. See, blockchain is a decentralized manner in which data will be stored, and it is an emerging technology. Which one is better for learning concepts, HackerRank or Kaggle? Rashi, actually HackerRank is not that much good, but HackerRank has many questions and you can answer them, but Kaggle will be of some use to specific courses. Okay, Shreya, sir, I joined late to class. I didn't understand what you said. What should I refer? Sir, you have to refer python.org for all the code that I did today, for all the programming code. Maybe the video is available. You can have a look from the start so that you can understand. And Pranav, can I use Ryzen instead of Intel? Ryzen is a newly introduced processor in the market, and we don't have sufficient experience over using Ryzen, so I don't have any answer for that. How is CSBS? Okay, I don't know about CSBS. We are not offering that course in Amrita University. Yes, certificates will be given. Can we run 3D graphs in Colab? Yes, of course, you can do that. Akshya, is programming different from coding? No, both are one and the same. Shavani. So what is meant by slicing? 1, 5, 3. So it will print up to 4, from 1 to 5. And 3 means 1. Afterwards, it will print the fourth element. 1 plus 3. That last 3 refers to step value, STEP. Okay, Rishi? Okay, I don't know about CSBS. I think I'm getting the same question again. What is the DEF in coding? Is it a command? Yes, of course, it's a definition actually, DEF. Yeah, you can run 3D graphs in Colab, Akshya. Okay, front-end, back-end, and full-stack development. See, front-end is nothing but designing your graphical user interfaces, like how to give input, how to show the output and all. Back-end is how data is stored. We use DBMS like SQL for that. Full-stack development is it's entirely different. Actually, we develop some web pages and all using this full-stack development. Yeah, cybersecurity has got very good future. How to get third-party packages in Colab? It's very simple. Import, for example, if you want Matplotlib, import Matplotlib. That's all. There is no thing called as neutron computing. We have only quantum computing, and we have neural computing. Okay, black box, white box testings, like, don't worry about that now. It is a way of testing the code, okay? AI or cybersecurity good? Both are equally good now. Sir, in which website can we learn about the GANs? Yeah, you can, I think you can refer sites like machinelearningmastery.com and towardsdatascience.com. You can learn about GANs in that. Many articles appear on GANs in that. Is 8 GB RAM sufficient, Manoj? Yes, of course, for Anaconda and all, 8 GB is sufficient. Blockchain technology emerging very strongly. Yes, of course. And I don't have any idea about Bitcoin and dollars and all. Please excuse me. Okay, wow, the same question, blockchain, okay. In CSE, will they teach program Arduino and Raspberry? Actually, Arduino and Raspberry Pi are small processors. And I don't think in CSE, we have an elective IoT and where we'll be teaching all those things. Which company should we prefer for our laptop? It depends upon your budget. If you have very good money, you can go for Apple MacBook, or you can prefer some companies like HP, Dell. I think I use a HP laptop. What will be the booming course in 2025? Yeah, Sumiki. I think CSE will be having good scope, CSE with AI. Close session, sir. Yeah, of course, you can leave if you don't have any queries. How to save coding? Actually, coding will be auto-saved in Colab, but if you use some other tools like Anaconda, we have Jupyter Notebook where you can save it just like file, save as, and give the file name. Okay. If you need to get input from the user, what we should do? You have to use input, INPUT, open bracket, close bracket. You have to use that command. Yes, yesterday's session link and all, I'll ask Nija Mohan ma'am to share it with you tomorrow. Yes, yeah, good.
Sir, this is to keep you informed that all the programs will be available in our webpage itself.
Yes.
In the webpage. So I'm sharing the link. So probably all the students can go there and then check for the updates. So this is to keep you informed. This session will be published by tomorrow or day after tomorrow, latest. So it will be published in the webpage. Okay. So you can check for this link in amrita.edu in the summer school 2021. Thank you. You can carry on, sir. So
yes, sir. I think there are no questions in the chat. Oh, 12 questions are there.
Okay. Yeah. Then we can wind up by 7. Almost it's 7:03. Okay. You yes, can sir. Take another few more minutes to complete it. Then we can
find out. Have mistake in code, will the website recognize and tell the mistake? No, website will not recognize that. It will show the error name, which you have to correct. Yeah, it will say that this line of code is having an error. It will. Is 16 GB RAM compulsory? No, it's not like that. 8 GB will do. How to clear a list? Yeah, list name .cler, open bracket, close bracket. Yeah, Shruti, AI is really good. It is the future of most of the industries, even mechanical industry, they are turning towards AI for manufacturing and all. It's really a wonderful thing. If you have a mistake in the code, will the website recognize? Yes, Colab will, any IDE will recognize that and it will say which line of the code is having that error. You can correct that pin. Okay. Yeah, I'm sorry. It's not by Vipin, but it is by name is Sanjeevan. Is it possible to do double degree in two different majors? No, actually, you cannot do two majors, but one major and one minor you can take. But I don't know about two majors. I don't think that's possible. Vipin. Yeah, Abhinav, we have a quiz on Saturday. Sir, should we learn anything in advance before coming to college? Yes, you should know basic mathematics. That's all. Nothing more. Okay, Manoj, it will show error only if the code has an error. Otherwise, it will not show that. maybe I don't know, you check what is the error it is showing and then try to correct that particular line. Yeah, thank you, Mahesh. Thank you for your feedback. And Guhan, do we have any PG course for CAI? What is CAI? Okay, quantum computing is an emerging area of computing, Joseph, and it uses quantum physics. Okay. What is the difference between 8 GB and 16 GB for the purpose of coding? Yeah, Vinay Vamsi, the session is already closed. I'm just answering the queries. If you don't have any queries, you can leave. Okay, if you have filled the attendance form. CSE with AI. Yes, we have CSE with AI. And machine learning is a part of AI. Okay, machine learning is a subset of AI. Sasi Kamal. CAI, computer science with AI. Yeah, we have MTech in AI. We have that MTech in cybersecurity. We have MTech in AI. Yes, we do offer PG courses in CAI. Okay. Will blockchain come under cybersecurity? There is a course in cybersecurity called as blockchain. Yes. Is quantum computing is advanced in only Google technologies? Yeah, many of the universities, they are doing good research in quantum computing. And Balaji, yes, sir, you are explaining very great. Yeah, thank you. Welcome, Balaji. Thanks for your feedback. Thank you, Joseph. Sasi Kamal, sir, if you want before notebook, then we should, what should I do, sir? You can see, go to that file, open notebook option will be there in Collab, Sasi Kamal. File, open notebook, you can see all the files already there, untitled one, untitled two, etc., which you can open. If you have given name, that name will be there. Sir, how can we choose BTech in AI? You have to join that course. Sai Subhash, you have typed some number, I don't know what it is, sorry. Sir, I am Dinesh. I want about mechanical. Dinesh, you can go to the admin page and see about mechanical engineering, the courses offered there, and etc. Okay. So, sir, do we have Java and JavaScript in CSE? Yes, of course. You have both these subjects. You'll be studying in CSE. What if a list have two identical max value? What will be the output? It will print only the one time. It will print that maximum value. Is your student settled in Google Pay area or job, sir? Yeah, few of the Amrita students are working in Google. Yeah, certificate will be provided for this course. AI tough? No, Shravani, AI is not tough. It is really a play game like thing. You just saw a few code, no? Something like that. Coding is very less, and you can do more wonders here. It's not that tough, but you have to work. What is the difference between 8 GB and 16 GB RAM? See, it's nothing but the applications that you are going to store. Okay, like 8 GB will be somewhat slow if you go for most of the machine learning applications, ML code and all. Okay, it'll take more time for the system to do that work. Whereas 16 GB, it'll do it somewhat faster. That's all. About Tribly, yeah, we have a session after 2 weeks. Maybe Tribly, they will ask about all those things. And sir, have AI Tribly phase 3 completed? I think, sir, can you answer, sir? Amudan, sir?
Yes. What is the question? Sorry.
Have AI Tribly phase 3 completed?
No. Yeah. AEEE phase 2 will going to happen on the coming days. Kindly check for the amrita.edu website. So you have everything clearly being given. If I say the dates now, you will get confused. So you just go there. It will be going to happen. The slot bookings are happening. So kindly go to the website and then check for the AEEE phase 2 examination. Phase 3 examinations will be intimated in the coming days. Thank you.
Yeah, thank you, sir. Is SSD necessary to store program files? No, it's not. Even a simple hard disk can do that. It's not a must.
Sir, which course has more scope, CSE, EC, or EEE? See, as of now, CSE, the placements are really good. Okay. EEE is best or mechanical? I don't know. I can't talk about that now. When you will provide the certificates? Okay, dear candidate, to know. Yeah, okay. Okay, yeah. I think, shall we wind up? Thank you, dear students. Thanks for joining. Thank you all. Actually, without writing AEEE with JE score, I think you can join. Am I correct, sir?
Yes, yes, very much.
Yes,
very
much. Yeah, Shravani, you can join with JEE score. Okay, thank you all. Thank you. Have a great day.
Thank you, sir. Thank you.
Yes, sir. Thank you, sir. We'll wind up. Yeah.